After studying this module, you shall be able to know about the hair, the structure of hair, general information related to the hair, the origin from hair, and identification of the site of hair. Hair, which comprises chiefly of the protein keratin, can be well defined as slender extension of the covering of mammals. Every class of animal retains hair with specific measurement, pigment, structure, root exterior and inner minute feature, which differentiate animals from each other. Substantial inconsistency also occurs in the kind of hairs which are present on the body of an animal. In human being, hairs present on the head, pubic area, arms, legs and other body areas have features that can govern their origin. In animals, hair kind consist of porous external hairs of guard hairs, the finer fur hairs, tangible hairs such as moustache and other hairs that initiate from tail and mane of an animal. Since hairs may be transferred during bodily contact, their existence can link a suspicious to a victim or a suspect or victim to a crime scene. The kind of hair found and the state and number of hair recovered all have influence on their importance as evidence in a criminal investigation. Evaluation of the minute characteristics of questioned hair to identify hair samples helps to govern whether a transmission may have occurred. Structure of hair. Hair strands has a complex arrangement consisting of numerous layers. If we start from the exterior, we find the cuticle, which comprises of layers of flat, thin, coinciding each other as roving lengths. Then the cortex, which comprises the keratin bundles in unevenly rod-like and cell structure. The medulla, that is disordered and exposed surface of the fibrous middle cuticle. Hair cuticle is hard and transparent. Each individual cuticle overlaps another like shinglings, stretching towards the end length of the each piece of hair. Dead cells, which form scales, forms the cuticle. Aside from protecting the inner layers of the hair, the cuticle also controls how much water can enter the hair. The shiny luster found on the hair of many people can be attributed to their cuticle cells. The structure of hair cuticle cells can vary. Some cells are elongated, oval-shaped or flattened. Others may have tapered ends. This varies allows for maximum coverage of other parts of hair, ensuring the best protection against injury or harm. Cortex. Cortex is a hollow cylindrical composed of fine fibers of protein material, comprises the majority of hairs and carries pigment material. They opposed to the main cortical component and are very beneficial in identification and individualization of the hair. Next comes the medulla. The medulla begins less or more near the root. In many animals, the medulla is very broad, occupying 2/3 or more of the shaft diameter. In man, it narrow, occupying only about 1/3 of the width. Medulla may be classified into two types, continuous or fragmented. The determination of the origin from the hair. A hair can be connected with a specific racial group grounded on recognized prototypes for every group. Forensic inspectors distinguish between hairs of Cascoid, that is European ancestry, from Mongoloid, that is Asian ancestry, and Negroid, that is African ancestry. Origin together, they exhibit minute features that differentiate one racial group from other. Head hairs are commonly reflected finest for determining race, while hairs from other body parts can be suitable. Racial determination from the minute inspection of head hairs from newborns, though it can be challenging, and hairs from person of diverse racial ancestry may have minute features recognized to more than one racial group. The identification of race is most valuable as an inspective tool, but then again it can also act as linking tool if a person's hair display uncommon racial features. The different types of hair. The diversity of various kinds of hair is enormous, inconsistent from close fitting lean curls to ruler straight. The pigment and form of hair differ. The type of hair you have is genetic from your ancestors. We may look back further and say that it is determined by the portion of the world in which your ancestor originate. Rest on the race or mixture of races from which they came. In the very initial days of human progression, three elementary racial collections of individuals appears to have happened on this earth. They extend out across the domain and turn out to be varied together. They are specifically well mixed in countries where there has been massive immigration, such as the USA, over the last few hundred years. Scientists have identified three basic types of hair in today's human population and have related them to these three early races, as I told you, Asian, Cascoid, and African. Cascoid, that is European. Hairs of this origin can be of sufficient to medium coarseness, are usually straight or wavy in look, and display shades ranging from pale to brown to black. The hair stand of Caucasian hair differs from round to oval in cross section and has reasonable to medium sized consistently distributed pigment granules. Mongoloid, that is the Asian. Hairs of Mongoloid or Asian origin are frequently rough, straight and round in cross section with a broad thickness than the hairs of former racial groups. The outer coating of the hair, the cuticle, is typically expressively denser than the cuticle of Negroid and Caucasian hair, and the medulla or central canal is continuous and wide. The hair shaft or cortex of Mongoloid hair comprises color grains that are usually bigger in size than the color grains of Caucasian hair and which frequently look like to be assembled in inconsistent areas inside the shaft. Mongoloid hairs can have distinct reddish look as a product of its pigment. Negroid or African. Hairs of Negroid or African origin are repeatedly curly or kinky, have a compressed cross section, and can look like curly, wavy, or twisted. Nigrod color greens are bigger than those originate in mongoloid and Caucasian hairs and are assembled in masses of dissimilar sizes and shapes. The thickness of the dye in the hair shaft can be so abundant as to make the hair denser. A nigroid hair shaft displays deviation or apparent variation in diameter because of its compressed nature and the method in which it lies on the optical microscope slide. Twisted hair shaft known as buckling can be existing and the hair shaft repeatedly separate along the dimension. Biological or environmental alteration. The minute look of hair is affected by usual biological variation and environmental effects. For this reason, it is significant that well-known hair principles are collected contemporaneously to the deposition of questioned hair. Head hairs are mainly affected by these issues, whereas pubic hairs are less influenced. A period of numerous months to years can diminish from a significant head their comparison, while some years may not rigorously influence on significance of pubic hair comparison. When hairs initiate from a body in a stage of decay, a black band may be seen near the root of the hair. This feature has been considered a postmortem root band. Human hair differs from animal hair. Hair comprises chiefly of the protein keratin, can be well defined as cylinder extensions of the skin of human being. Each class of animal owns hair with distinctive shape, pigment, size, root, form, and interior minute features that differentiate one animal from another. Significant inconsistency also extend in these kinds of hair that is present on the body of an animal. In human being, hair set up on head, pubic region, arms, legs, and other body areas have features that can determine their origin. In animals, hair types comprise rough outer hair or guard hairs. The better quality fur hairs, tangible hairs such as mustache and other hairs that divide from tail and mane of an animal. Hairs can be transferred through bodily contact. Their existence can assist a suspect to a victim or a victim or suspect to a crime scene. The kind of hair found and the state and number of hairs found all influence on their value of evidence in a criminal examination. Evaluation of the minute features of the questioned hair to call hair samples aids to govern whether a transfer may have occurred. This forensic comparison of hair. Hair is a common type of evidence submitted to the trace section for analysis. On average, humans shed approximately 100 head hairs per day. Because we are continuously shedding hairs, forensic analysis hairs is beneficial to the establishment of association between individuals, a person and an environment, etc. For example, a questioned hair from a victim's genes is examined and found to be consistent with the suspect's hair. This examination has provided evidence that an association may have occurred between the suspect and the victim. The inspection of mammal hairs in forensic research laboratory is classically performed by the help of light microscopy. This scrutiny routinely includes a two-step process: the recognition of disputed hairs and the comparison of disputed and known hairs. The determination for conducting this examination is to establish whether two or more persons could have come into interaction, or whether one or more person could have come into interaction with an object. This linking evidence is mainly helpful in offenses of violence such as killing, rape, and serious assault, where physical contact could have occurred. Offenses such as theft and armed theft characteristically include the retrieval of remains and objects of clothing which can comprise hairs valuable for identification of the suspects. The importance of hair evidence is associated to the inconsistency of hair features among persons in the people, which can be imagined by the use of the comparison microscopy. There are several features that influences the dependability of a hair question, together with experience, training, appropriateness of recognized hair standards, and advocacy of equipment. The first is to determine whether the hair is disputed device from an animal or a mammal. If the hair devised from an animal, it is probable to further recognize it to a specific kind of animal, though definite hairs can be attributed to species. It is not likely to recognize hairs to a specific animal to the elimination of other comparable animals. Animal hairs reveal on the substance of physical evidence can relate a suspicious or position to a crime of violence. A target position in a vehicle or held at a site where animals are regularly found frequently, outcome in the transmission of an animal hair to the victim's clothing. Cat or dog hairs can be found on the glue portion of pavement and blackmail notes made by pet owners. The transmission of the pet hairs to the target or crime scene may also happen when the suspicious is a pet owner and has animal hairs on his or her clothing when the contact occurs. This brings up to a secondary transmission of trace substances. When an animal hair is present, it is recognized to a specific kind of animal and minutely matched with a well-known hair sample from either an animal hair reference collection from or a specific animal. If the disputed hair displays the same minute features as the identified hairs, it is established that the hair is constant with originating from the animal. It is noted, however, that the animal hairs do not retain enough specific microscopic features to be linked with a specific animal to the elimination of other similar animals. Hair suitability for DNA examination. Nuclear DNA analysis can be done on human hairs. The trace section assists the DNA section by the screening hairs and determining the suitability for DNA testing. A microscope is used to examine the root end of the hairs in order to determine if they are suitable. If a hair is deemed not suitable for nuclear DNA analysis, that is, number of root present or no tissues attached, it can be sent for mitochondrial DNA testing. A root does not have to present in order for a hair to be suitable for mitochondrial DNA testing. Now let us summarize what we have learned in this module. Hair analysis can specify whether the source is human or animal, and also whether the source is a member of a particular race. It can determine if the hair have been colored, cut in a certain way or pulled out, and where on the body it was located. In some cases, signs of poisoning show up in the hair. The hair strand with the follicle can also suggest genetic determination such as blood category or DNA, and meanwhile the exterior layer of the shaft registers putrefaction. It's a kind of evidence that has real remaining power. Necroid hairs are kinky with the dense pigments, while quaternary hairs are generally straight or wavy with finer pigmentation. Pigment distribution is also different between two races. The hair of a baby or a young child tends to be finer than the adult hair, but it is difficult to establish gender from the hair sample. Hair is a common type of evidence submitted to the trace section for analysis. On average, human shed approximately 100 head hairs per day. Nuclear DNA analysis can be done on human hairs. This trace section assists the DNA section by screening hairs and determining their suitability for DNA testing.